We're getting breaking news that the Lahore High Court has ordered the government of Pakistan to immediately release Zakir Ur Rahman Lakhvi from detention. Hamza Amir is now joining us with the very latest. Hamza, why has this order come from the Lahore High Court?
Well, interestingly enough, Zakir Rahman Lakhvi's bail plea, since the time it was actually accepted that he's a free man to walk on bail and the government should actually release him immediately, he still stayed in detention, and he actually challenged that decision of the government in the court that he's been kept in detention illegally and he should be released immediately. That this petition and this challenge was done in two courts, one in Islamabad High Court and one in the Lahore High Court. And today Lahore High Court gave decision in favor of Zakir Rahman Lakhvi that he should be released and freed at immediate effect, and the government should not actually, you know, put him in any further detention, because as per the law, he's a man who was free to walk on bail. As per the investigation is going on, he will be brought back to the court when required, but for now, he should be freed as per the court orders.
Also, is the government showing any inclination towards appealing against that order?
For now, because the decision has just come out, the government has not given its stance. But yes, it is expected that the government will come up with some other reason to actually put him in detention, as they did before, that he should be put in jail and put in detention because of the public protection ordinance. And they will, I think, you know, do the same on other cases, because Zakir Rahman Lakhvi is not only convicted in one case of the Mumbai terror attack, he's also has got several other cases in other courts. So if one court actually decides to, order of his release, then they can use always other channels and other cases to put him back in detention.
Hamza, help us understand that the order that the Lahore High Court has given today, does it come specifically with regards to the Mumbai terror attack case?
No, it is not actually related to the Mumbai terror attack case, because that case is going on in the Islamabad High Court. This is a separate case against him on kidnapping and also on murder charges that was actually filed against him. And because of that case, he was basically contending the fact that he is a man on bail and he should be freed and allowed to walk. And the Lahore High Court today had decided on a separate case. It is not related to the Mumbai terror attack case, mm-hmm. because on the Mumbai terror attack case, Zakir Rahman Lakhvi was granted bail by the Islamabad High Court, and since then he has been in detention. So the government's contention would actually come on that particular case rather than this case, because this is something that is a decision that can be challenged in any other court.
All right, so what exactly is the government doing on the 2008 Mumbai attack case, the terror attack that was masterminded by Zakir Rahman Lakhvi? What is the Pakistan government stand on that at the moment? Any inclination by the Pakistan government to get him behind bars over that?
Right now, the Pakistan government has kept itself away from any official statement on the Mumbai terror attack case. They have said that it is actually going on as part of the investigation in the Pakistan courts, and they will actually leave it to the courts to decide what actually is the decision on that. Pakistan government is only using its authority to actually put Zakir Rahman Lakhvi in detention. And that detention always, comes back into question after a month or after every 3 months, because that is the maximum time of detention that they can keep him in. And they only give security reasons and, threats of hate speeches that actually Zakir Rahman Lakhvi has done in the past. So Pakistan government's stance is pretty much dependent on what the court proceedings are. But as far as the court is concerned, the investigation is underway, and there are several questions that are actually brought up. That the statements that have been taken from India or the Indian side are in Hindi, and they should be actually translated. And there are certain other reasonings being created basically to actually linger the case forward, because Zakir Rahman Lakhvi's case is a prime concern for the Pakistan government, and obviously these concerns were raised during the Indian Foreign Secretary's visit as well. So Pakistan is actually trying to play it as safe as possible and trying to give it as much time as possible.
All right, Hamza, I'm requesting you to stay on with us. Gaurav Sawant, Strategic Affairs Editor, is also joining us with a perspective on the story. Gaurav, Hamza tells us that this particular case where the Lahore High Court has ordered the government of Pakistan to immediately release Zakir Rahman Lakhvi is not the Mumbai terror attack case. But still, the fact that the Pakistan government is not taking a strong stand against him does it betray the fact that they perhaps do not want to do anything about it?
That is what it appears so many years after 26/11 Mumbai terror attacks. And Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi, is just one of the masterminds of this operation. India has constantly been saying, these seven that you have in jail, go after them, but go after Hafiz Mohammed Saeed. And that is something that Pakistan has steadfastly refused to do. As far as Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi, alias Chacha, is concerned, what the Pakistan administration has been doing is they keep him in jail under various detention orders, but that falls foul of the court. They're not prosecuting him in the 26/11 Mumbai terror attacks. Given the mountain of evidence there is there, they still are not prosecuting him. They just keep him under a prevention of detention order. And because of that, the courts say release him. And then, like they did with Hafiz Mohammed Saeed on a court order, released Hafiz Mohammed Saeed but did not take action against him. So, you know, Pakistan administration, the government, is running with the hare and hunting with the hounds, not going after these masterminds of terror in the right earnest.
That's absolutely correct, and as you were pointing out there, and even Hamza, that they are keeping him in detention only for a couple of months, and then of course the court order allows his release. Gaurav, also take us through the mountain of evidence that you're talking that India has given to Pakistan in the Mumbai terror attack case, which Pakistan has in the past dismissed as literature.
Look, this is now 7 years after the 26/11 Mumbai terror attacks. The evidence includes not just a testimony of Ajmal Amir Kasab, the Pakistani terrorist who was arrested alive in 26/11, and this was a statement made before a judicial magistrate, so which is admissible as evidence in court, not just in India, but since Pakistan follows a similar legal system, it's also admissible as evidence in Pakistan. So there's Ajmal Amir Kasab's statement, there are video recordings, voice recordings, intercepts. There is also Abu Jindal's statement. Abu Jindal was present in that Karachi safe house, you know, which was the control room where 26/11 Mumbai terror attacks were being directed. His statement is there, made before again a judicial magistrate in India after Abu Jindal was extradited and brought to India. So there is a mountain of evidence. David Coleman Headley, what he had told the FBI in a U.S. court, that is there. So in case Pakistan wants to prosecute Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi, there is a mountain of evidence. And as Government of India has constantly been saying, Maha, that use this as the basis to do your own investigation. This is as much in Pakistan's interest, since Pakistan claims it is also suffering suffering terror and is a victim of terror. So it is in Pakistan's interest to investigate these cases in the right earnest and go after terror perpetrators. Sadly, Pakistan refuses to do that, and you have Pakistani diplomats who claim that this is not evidence, it's literature.
Let me go back to Hamza Amir, who's joining us with the very latest from Pakistan. Hamza, can you give us a sense of what the Pakistan government is likely to do now in this particular case that went to the Lahore High Court?
Well, I think the Pakistan government will do exactly what they've done in the past. They've actually, you know, going to bring out more reasons to actually continue his detention in jail, and that detention can be for 30 more days or 60 more days. They're actually trying to give it as much time as possible, and that is basically a delay tactic. Not only does it flout the orders of the court when they say that he's a free man to walk, it also actually, you know, brings them into a perspective that Pakistan's government's interests are actually coinciding with the courts. While on the other hand, Pakistan government has been saying that it will be the courts that will decide the fate of Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi and Hafiz Mohammed Saeed. Because Gaurav Sawant was right. Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi is one man. Hafiz Saeed is another. Hafiz Saeed roams around free in Pakistan. His organization is banned, yet they hold public rallies in Pakistan.
Okay.
They have their proper operations inside every corner of Pakistan.
Okay.
So if that on one side, Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi can be put in detention, the other prime suspect of the Mumbai terror attack is a free man to walk. And that is where, you know, the government comes into a cycle of uncertainty. And they try to do their best to linger
the process. Okay, Hamza, I'll hold you there for a bit. Let's also get a legal perspective from Ujwal Nikam. Mr. Nikam, if you can help us understand this case of Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi, taken into detention for a little while, and then the court, of course, says that these grounds are not enough to hold him back behind bars. Does Pakistan betray a sense of not being sincere in going after Zakir Ur Rahman, Lakhvi?
I'm very sorry to say that all these efforts which were made by the Pakistani authorities were are again exposed by the today's order of the Lahore High Court for the simple reason. They were only concentrating that Lakhvi should be detained in jail. My basic question is that why they did not adduce the evidence of a criminal conspiracy in Pakistan designated court, that is a trial court, wherein the trial against Lakhvi was conducted, is the first question. Second question is the criminal conspiracy was hatched on the soil of the Pakistan. So it was for the Pakistani investigating agency to collect that evidence instead of blaming India. Thirdly, whatever the evidence which we have collected, that is so far as the oversight in respect of the committed by the 10 terrorists on the night of the 26th November, that was already given and furnished to the Pakistani authority. And therefore, the Pakistan Judicial Commission had visited Mumbai and they have cross-examined, including Lakhvi's lawyer, Mr. Abbasi, had visited Mumbai and cross-examined the magistrate who had recorded the confession of Kasab, the investigating officer, Indian investigating officer who had investigated the entire crime. Now, this evidence was not properly presented before the Pakistan trial court in a prospective manner. These are all the facts. So whatever the Lahore High Court has passed an order, that is perfectly legal because the Lahore High Court has said that Lakhvi cannot be detained on the flimsy ground. Mm-hmm. So why, my basic question is that why Lakhvi's role in respect of the criminal conspiracy was not properly presented before the Pakistan trial court?
Okay.
That is the precise question.
Mr. Nikam, when you say that evidence was not properly presented, could you help us understand what you mean by that? Are you saying that the lawyers were not presenting the proper picture before the court?
See, I'm not aware actually what Pakistani prosecuting agency had produced that evidence.
Hmm.
But basically, the criminal conspiracy was hatched on the soil of the Pakistan before the 26th November.
Okay.
And that evidence was required to be collected by them instead of blaming India. Why I fail to understand why they are blaming India, that India should not have furnished the evidence. In fact, we have given the evidence in respect of the oversight committed by the 10 conspirators.
That's a very important point you're making there, sir. Criminal conspiracy, something that that Pakistan needs to do due diligence over. Is that what you're saying? Because that was hatched on their soil.
Absolutely, that is my basic contention. So all the while I was apprehending, that detention order of the Pakistan government is then just eyewash, showing to the whole world that we are very serious and we will see that Lakhvi should not be released. Why Pakistani prosecuting agency had not challenged the basic order of release from the bail? Why Pakistani investigating agency did not adduce the material evidence in respect of the criminal conspiracy?
Mm-hmm.
This is a basic question. These are required to be answered by the Pakistani authorities.
And sir, at this present moment, what do you have to say about the way, the manner in which even a person like Hafiz Mohammad Saeed is walking about free in Pakistan?
See, myself and the three other Indian high officials had visited Islamabad after the execution of Kasab. We pointed out the Pakistani prosecuting agency, this is the material evidence, you have to marshal that evidence. Lakhvi should be tried for criminal conspiracy for killing 106 persons.
Hmm.
They did not charge him specifically. That is my grievance.
All right, Ujwal Nikam, they're making
a very pertinent point
about criminal conspiracy and that Pakistan needs to do due diligence over it because the evidence that India has provided is about the attack, the Mumbai terror attack, but the conspiracy was hatched on Pakistan's soil and Pakistan has not done enough to unearth that conspiracy. Many thanks, Ujwal Nikam, for speaking with Headlines today.